The secret to a perfect speed ramp is something you'd never expect. It has nothing to do with specific settings, adding motion blur, easing keyframes, or anything else you heard before. It comes down to three core concepts top editors always use but never talk about, leaving you with the same generic advice you hear everywhere. But don't worry, because in the next 5 minutes you'll learn about these secret concepts and the full editing process behind the perfect speed ramp. By the way, I'm Matt, I'm a full-time video editor, and I'm here to show you everything I've learned about video editing over the past 8 years. Imagine this, you're a pro driver and you get challenged to beat the track record. Green light hits and you set off. The thing is, the track is trash, full of bumps, cracks and holes. Doesn't matter how skilled you are, your ride's gonna look rough. Speedrumps work the same way, they're all about flow and momentum. But if your footage is choppy, shaky and all over the place, no amount of editing can make it smooth. The true secret behind the perfect speedrump is perfect footage. But what makes the perfect footage? Well, it comes down to these three simple concepts. I guarantee your speedrumps will be smooth as butter if you look out for these three things. Let me ask you something, where would you feel more comfortable? Driving on the highway in a nice limousine or off-roading in an old truck? Of course you would feel better in the limousine cruising on the highway. Why? Because it would be a much smoother experience. And that's what you want to aim for when selecting footage for speedrumps. There's nothing that will make a speedrump smoother than smooth footage itself. You should be looking for steady movement with nice stabilization, ideally shot on gimbal or dolly. This is extremely important to making great speedrumps. But the next concept is the single biggest factor to making your speedrumps feel seamless. See these three shots? This is the starting shot and two options for the second one. The starting shot looks like this. Which of these two do you think will work better? Let's try the first one. Okay, not bad. Now the second one. See how smooth it looks compared to the first option? Both shots are pretty smooth. However, the second one feels a lot better for some reason. Well, it's because of the matching movement. Matching movement is a game changer if you want to make a seamless speedrump transition. It doesn't matter if the two shots are punching in, punching out, or rotating around the subject. Matching the movement between the shots will take your speedrumps to the next level. However, there's one thing that will make your speedrumps even better. Our eyes are structured in a way where we can focus only on one thing. For example, when your subject is on the left side of the frame, you can't really focus on what's on the other side. So what if you go from one shot where the focus is on the right to another where the focus is on the left? Well, the viewer's eyes will have to travel across the entire screen. It will make it quite hard for the viewer to process it. But if your subject stays in roughly the same spot, the viewer will understand what's going on right away. This technique is called eye trace. It's crucial for edits that are really fast-paced. And if you want to do speed ramps, I assume you're going for a fast-paced edit. If you follow these three things while picking shots, you're off to a super smooth speed ramp. But none of it will matter if you don't know how to edit it. Let's jump into the program and I'll show you the exact process behind editing speed ramps. I'll also give you a couple of tricks that will take your speed ramps to the next level. The easiest way to do a speed ramp is to right click the FX icon on the right side of your clip, then timer mapping and speed. To place the keyframe, you can hold Ctrl and click. You can also click the keyframe icon in the effects panel. After that, you can drag up the part of the shot that you want to speed up. That will give you a harsh transition from normal speed to high speed. Sometimes it might be what you're looking for, but if you want to have a smooth speed ramp, you can drag this marker to make it ramp up. If you want to smooth it out even more, you can ease the keyframe. You can do it by dragging the center of the ramp to the right. This will give you a super smooth speed ramp. There's no specific setting that makes a perfect speed ramp. Sometimes 300% might work and sometimes 3000 will be perfect. It all depends on the clip and the effect you want to go for. Just play around with it and adjust it to where you feel it looks nice. After you have both clips sped up, you have nice transition like this. Now let me show you a couple more tricks to making your speed ramp look even better. I often add effects on top of my speed ramp to make it look smoother. For example, I love to use flashes. They can hide the imperfections and add a bit more impact to your speed ramp. You can also use other transitions like light leaks or even adding a shake effect on top of your speed ramp. And last but not least, motion blur. There are a couple of paid plugins that allow you to add motion blur directly in Premiere, but you can also do it in After Effects. Select the shots you want to add motion blur to, right click and replace with After Effects composition. Once you're in After Effects, right click on your timeline, new and adjustment layer. Search for an effect called pixel motion blur. Drag it to the adjustment layer and adjust the settings to your liking. The higher shutter angle, the more blur you will get. Increasing shutter samples will make your motion blur higher quality, but it will make it slower to process. I don't really have any specific settings I go for here, it all depends on the shots. After that, you can cut out the parts of the adjustment layer where you don't need motion blur and you're good to go. Bonus tip, your footage doesn't have a lot of movement, but you want to use it anyway. You can fake it in the edit. It also works wonders if you want to make your speedrun more dynamic. You can animate the scale of your rogue clip. For example, let's go for zooming out motion. I'll scale up the beginning of the shot to about 200 and do the same thing for the other clip. And after you do the speed ramp, it acts as if the zooming movement was in the original footage. I'm 100% sure your speed ramps will be way better if you use the things I mentioned today. But it doesn't matter if you don't understand how to use them in practice. Click on this video to see a full edit breakdown showing how I use speed ramps and other effects. Subscribe if you like the video, because there will be a lot more coming. See you in the next one.